Good morning, children. Welcome to your math class. Today we are going to study new lesson, lesson 1 division from your term 1B textbook. What is meant by division? Yes, we already studied in the last year. Division means dividing things equally into groups. And we also know that division is exactly the opposite of multiplication. So, we need to know multiplication tables very well to perform division. So, let's start our class. Okay, so first we are going to study division of 3-digit numbers by 1-digit number using long division method. Okay, so first question, look here, 784 divided by 7. Here, 784 is a 3-digit number and 7 is a 1-digit number. So here, look here children, here we are dividing 784 by 7 and the number to be divided, here we are dividing 784 by 7, no. So the number to be divided is called dividend. So in this case, the dividend is 784. 784 is the dividend. The number to be divided is called dividend and by which it is divided is called divisor. So in this case, the divisor is 7. Okay, understood the two terms. The number to be divided is called dividend and by which it is divided is called divisor. Okay, children. So, let's start. So, here first you want to write the numbers like this. 784 divided by 7. Okay. Then, first step, we want to take the first digit. Okay. So, here the first digit is 7. And check whether first digit is greater than or equal to the divisor. Here the divisor is 7 and the first digit is also 7 here. 7 is equal to 7, so no problem. If the first digit is less than the divisor, then we want to take 2 digits. Okay, so here in this case, the first digit is equal to the divisor, so no problem. We can divide. Okay, then look here in the multiplication table of 7, whether we are getting 7 into any number, whether we are getting this first digit, that is 7, as the product. Look here, yes, 7 into 1 is equal to 7. We are getting 7 as the product. So we can write 7 into 1 above this 7 we want to write. 7 into 1 is, I'm getting the product 7. Okay. Then, next what we want to do is, we want to subtract. We want to subtract. 7 minus 7, it is 0. Okay. Then, next step, here we get 0. Next step, we want to bring down the second digit. Okay. We want to bring down the second digit, that is here 8. And look here, 8 is greater than the divisor, so no problem, we can divide. Okay, then check whether we are getting 8 as the product in the multiplication table of 7. No, it is not the product. So, next you want to check in the multiplication table whether we are getting the product which is nearer to 8 and less than 8. Okay. And the product which is nearer to 8 and less than 8. Here, 7 into 1 is equal to 7. 7 into 2 is equal to 14. It is greater than 8. So, it is not possible to take 14. So, you want to take 7 into 1 is equal to 7. It is less than 8 and nearer to 8. Okay, children. So, we can write 7 into 1. 1 we want to write above 8, that is about 10th place digit. 7 into 1 is 7. Okay. Next step, we want to subtract. Okay, look here. What is 8 minus 7? 8 minus 7 is 1. So we can write 1. Then here it is 0. No, writing 0 before a number means there is no value. So we want to write only 8 minus 7, that is 1. Okay, next step, here 1 is less than the divisor. 1 is less than the divisor, so it is not possible to divide. So we want to bring down the third digit also. Okay, that is 4. Now the number becomes 14. Okay, it is greater than the divisor, so we can divide. No problem. Look here in the multiplication table of 7, whether we are getting 14 as the product. Yes, 7 into 2 is equal to 14. So we can write 7 into 2. We want to write this above 4, and 7 into 2 is 14. Okay, next step, we want to subtract. What is 4 minus 4? It is 0. 1 minus 1, it is 0. Okay, so here we get 0, and there is no other number here to bring down, so we can stop here. Okay, children, then the number we are getting above, this is the answer in division, and answer in division is called quotient. Okay, the answer in division is called quotient. We can denote it as capital Q. And look here, what is the quotient we have get here? 112. This is the answer we got here. Then the zero, the last number, the leftover number. Here we get zero. The leftover number is called the remainder. Here we get zero. Okay. The leftover number is called the remainder. And the answer in division is called the quotient. Okay, children, understood how we done the division using long division method? Okay, children, we can do one more problem. Look here, 558 divided by 6. Okay, so first you want to write like this, 558 divided by 6. Okay, so tell me, what is the dividend here? Here the dividend is 558, and the divisor is 6. The divisor is 6. Okay, then what you want to do first? You want to check the first digit. What is the first digit here? It is 5. 5 is the first digit, and you want to check whether it is greater than or equal to the divisor. Here 5 is less than the divisor, so we want to take 2 digits. Okay, we want to take 2 digits, that is here 55. Okay, 55 is greater than the divisor, so no problem, we can divide. Okay, next, check in the multiplication table whether we are getting 55 as the product. 55, no, 55 is not the product in the multiplication table of 6. Okay, then check whether we are getting 6 into any number, whether we are getting the product which is less than 55 and near to 55. Okay, look here, 6 into 9 is equal to 54, and 6 into 10 is equal to 60. It is greater than 55, so it is not possible to take 6 into 10 is equal to 60. So you want to take 6 into 9 is equal to 54. 54 is less than 55 and near to 55. Okay, so we can write 6 into 9. 9 we want to write about 10th place digit, because here we are taking 2 digits, 55. Okay, so you want to write 9 above this 10th place digit. That is 6 into 9 is 54. 54. Okay. Next, what is the next step? We want to subtract. We want to subtract. That is 5 minus 4 is 1. Then 5 minus 5 is 0. Okay. So here we get 1. 1 is less than the divisor. So we want to bring down the third digit also. This is 8. So we want to bring down 8. Now the number become 18. 18 is greater than the divisor. So no problem, we can divide. Okay, so check whether we are getting 18 as the product. Yes, 6 into 3 is equal to 18. So we can write 6 into 3. 3 we can write above 8. Okay, 6 into 3 is 18. So we can write 18 here. Then what's the next step? We want to subtract. Okay, so what is 8 minus 8? It is 0. And 1 minus 1? It is also 0. Okay, then there is no other number here to bring down. So we can stop here. Then tell me, what is the answer in division? It is the number above here. So that is 93. It is called the quotient. So here we get the quotient as 93. Okay, quotient is 93. It is the answer in division. And what is the remainder? Here also we have 0. The remainder is 0. Okay, children, understood how to divide using long division method? Okay, children, we can do one word problem. Look here. Mohit packs 8 balls in one box. How many boxes will be needed to pack 168 balls? Okay, it's a word problem. So, we want to write the steps. So, what are given here? Mohit packs 8 balls in one box. So, number of balls in one box is given. It is 8. Okay, then how many boxes will be needed to pack 168 balls? So, total balls is also given. Total balls is 168. So, what we want to find? How many boxes will be needed? So, number of boxes needed we want to find. So, what are given? Number of balls in one box is given. It is 8. And total balls, it is 168. We want to find number of boxes needed to pack this 168 balls. Okay. So, how we are finding? We want to divide this total balls by number of balls in one box. That is 168 divided by 8. Okay, so we can do it here. 168 divided by 8. Look here, the first digit is 1, but 1 is less than 8, less than the divisor. So we want to take the two digits, that is 16. Okay, 16 is greater than 8. Okay, then check in the multiplication table of 8 whether we are getting 16 as the product. Yes, 8 into 2 is 16. So 8 into 2, we can write about 6. 8 into 2 is 16. Okay. Then next step is we want to subtract. We want to subtract 16 minus 16. That is 6 minus 6. It is 0. And 1 minus 1. It is also 0. Next, we want to, this here we have 0. So we want to bring down this 8. Okay. So 8. And look here. 8 is equal to 8. And look here in the multiplication table, we are getting 8 into 1 is equal to 8. So we can write 8 into 1 above this 8, and 8 into 1 is 8. Next step, we want to subtract. Okay, what is 8 minus 8? It is 0. Okay, 0, here also 0. So writing a 0 before number, no value, so no need to write that. So there is no other numbers here to bring down, so we can stop here. So tell me, here the remainder is 0. Here the remainder is 0, and we are getting the answer as 21. Okay, so here we get the answer as 21. So number of boxes needed is 21. Understood, children? Okay, children, so only this much for today. Study well. Write your notes neatly. Okay, children. Thank you.